Hello, my lovely yogis. Welcome back to Sash Yoga class. Today we will do some wall yoga poses workout. We will help ourselves with the wall. First pose is goddess pose, Utkata Konasana. Spread your legs like 5 feet apart. Then use the wall. Lift up your hands. Bend them a little bit. And make sure that you keep hands and your back all way on the wall. Don't forget to breathe in this pose. You can put hands on your chest if you feel some back pain or tight pain. Just lift up your body and then do it one more time. It's great how wall can help us in any single pose we are going to do today. Just follow my instructions. So that was our first pose. Our second pose is going to be Virabhadrasana tree. Before we start with this pose, shake one leg, shake the other leg. Always relax your muscle. So find the wall, move a little bit back from the wall, and then press your head down. Make sure that your back and your legs are straight. Both hands on the wall. And arms should be closer to our ear. On inhale, lift up our body a little bit. On exhale, head down, body down. Stay here for a few seconds. And then we will lift one leg up. So this is Virabhadrasana tree. There is some variation. You can put left hand closer to your body, right hand stays on the wall. When you're done with this pose, bring both legs together. Put left hand on the wall. Exhale, let's go down a little bit. Now lift up your left leg in the air. Virabhadrasana tree, warrior tree. Variation is to put right hand closer to your body, just to keep balance. You don't have to. Put both hands on the wall, bring both legs together, exhale, down. Next pose is going to be chair pose, Utkatasana. So we will use a wall again, turn around, move from the wall a little bit. Let's imagine that you have a chair and we will sit on the chair, but we are using the wall to help ourselves a little bit. Hands should be next to our body. Don't forget to breathe here. If you feel any pain, just stop doing this pose. After this pose, we will do King Dancer pose or Natarajasana. So first we will go in Virabhadrasana one more time, just to stretch our back before King Dancer pose. You can skip this, but it feels very good after chair pose. King Dancer pose, left hand on the wall, with right hand we are grabbing right foot, lift up in the air at the back. If you feel that you have a balance, you can keep your hand in the air, connect thumb and pointer. But if you feel that you will lose balance, you put left hand on the wall. When you're done with this pose, hug the knee, bring forehead closer to your knee, then relax one leg, relax the other leg, shake them. Let's do the other side. Right hand on the wall, left hand, we are grabbing left foot. We are helping ourselves with the wall. That was King Dancer pose. Next pose is going to be half moon pose or Ardha Chandrasana. Move from the wall. Inhale, exhale, hands down. And then, in this case, right leg goes up and we are putting the leg on the wall. When we find the balance, then we will lift up our right hand in the air. Half moon pose. When we're done with this pose, bring both hands together, both legs together, and then we will press our knee with our hand, just to stretch our lower back. Both hands on the floor, we are lifting our left leg, we find the wall, we are pressing the wall, and then we will open our chest by lifting our left hand in the air. Always one part of the body is more flexible than the other one. Keep that in the mind when you're doing every pose. Bring both hands together, both legs together. Press the hands on your knees. Shake one leg, shake the other leg. Virabhadrasana one more time. Just to stretch yourself a little bit. And then our next pose is going to be camel pose. You will go on your knees. We will do this pose with the wall, but I'm just showing you how the pose should look like. So you have to tuck your toes, spread them 1 foot apart, and then find your heels with your hands and then put head at the back. The point of this pose is to not move the hips. That's why we are using the wall, so it can learn us how to not move the hips when we do this pose. So press the hips on the wall, find the heels with your hands and put head at the back as much as you can. Don't forget to breathe here. When you're done with this pose, we will do child pose just to relax. Sorry, not child pose. We will do legs up to the wall pose. So lift our legs up, press them on the wall, put hands on the side. Stay here as much as you want. Close your eyes. Make sure that you breathe. Relax. Feel the space around you. You can put left hand on the heart, right hand on your stomach, just to feel heart beating. Or you can stay with your hands on the side. There is some variation here, you can do it. Make sure that you breathe through your nose. Inhale, exhale. Usually when we inhale, it's about 4 seconds. When we do exhale, it's 8 seconds. The other variation is to put one leg on the floor. In this case, it's left one. And you keep your hands on the side. Then you can swap the legs. I would not recommend this variation if you have hip injury or if you did some hip surgery. If not, you can try this variation. When you're done with this pose, bring both legs up to the wall. And stay a few more seconds, breathe. Slowly bend the knee, or you can do some push-ups. Lift your body up. That's just variations of this pose. When you're done, bend the knee and put them on the side. And now we will go to child pose. Just to stretch our lower back a little bit. Before our next pose. So next pose is hand to big toe pose. So lift up left leg, put on the wall, both hands on the side. So basically we should grab our big toe with our left hand. This is how it looks like, and right hand is on the side. Make sure that both legs are straight. And you can do variation, revolved hand to big toe pose. With right hand, we are grabbing left big toe. That's why we're using the wall. Shake one leg, shake the other leg. Now right leg up to the wall. Hands on the side. And we are grabbing our big toe with the right hand. And then we will do a revolved hand to big toe pose. Try to grab your big toe with your left hand. One more pose when using the wall. Shake one leg, shake the other leg. So last pose is garland pose, malasana. Spread your feet 1 foot apart. Hands on namaste. And slowly we are going down, we are helping ourselves with the wall, and we will go to Malasana. Stay here as much as you want, don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching my yoga class. I hope you enjoy, see you next time, bye!